in all torn clothes, hungry, and they look up. Oh, why are these people bothering me? I don't have time for them. She slammed her door and went back in. Later in the day, there was another knock, a little old lady. She could hardly stand up, and she said, "Can I have a drink?" The lady slammed her door. "I don't have time. I'm preparing for the master." She was too busy to see the master through those three people. Then in the evening, later in the evening, there was a knock. This well-dressed man. "Oh," she said, "this must be the master. I'm going to let him in." She said, "Come on in." He said to her, "Three times today I've been here, and you slammed your door and me. Why do you want me in now? Because I'm all dressed?" She said, "Yes, I were preparing for you. You see, boys and girls, as children of God, Jesus put me here to minister to everyone. Don't care what the situation is, whether we dress properly or however. If someone is hungry, we have to feed them, and if someone needs clothes, we have to." In Matthew chapter 25, verse 41 and 42 said, "I was hungry, and he took me not in, naked, and he clothed me not, sick and in prison, and he visited me not. Then shall they also answer him, saying, Lord, when was we hunger and thirst, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, and in prison, and we did not minister unto thee?" You are small, but inside of school you learn to minister to people. Not because they are well-dressed, not because it's your friend. Whoever you come in contact with, who need your help, please try and help them. Because when you are helping them, you are doing what the Lord expects of us to do. Okay? So remember this lesson. Ministering to people does not... You don't have to be well-dressed for them to minister to them. Whatever way they are ministering to them, they are all God's children. At this time, we have one prayer. And this story does not go for the children only, but for the adults also.
lifting you unto you, the servant of the Lord, choose you this day whom you would serve. Whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites, in whose land ye dwell. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. For the Lord our God, he it is that brought us up, and our fathers out of the land of Egypt, from the house of bondage, and which did those great signs in our sight, and preserved us in all the ways wherein we went, and among all the people with whom we passed altogether. And the Lord drave out from before us all the people, even the Amorites which dwelt in the land. Therefore we will also serve the Lord, for he is our God. And the Lord at Christmas is reading here to the Jews of Israel.
Thank you. because I say so.
Great is your faithfulness. I didn't hear about amen, but if the Lord has been good to you, great is your faithfulness. She saw the storm morning by morning. New mercies I see. Every time we open our eyes in the morning, we see new mercies and new blessings from God. Great is his faithfulness. That's why we get excited when we come into his presence, because when we come into this place, we just come to let him know how good he has been to us. After keeping us and guiding us and protecting us for the week, all we can come, when we come into his house, all we can say, Lord, thank you for your faithfulness. Why? We didn't deserve it. We didn't work for it. But because of your love and your grace to us, great is your faithfulness unto us. We want to thank Marsha for blessing us today. We thank God for her and for her ministry and music. And I pray that the Lord will be with her as she continues to use that beautiful voice to sing to his name, honor, and glory. Great is his faithfulness. Turn your Bibles with me to our scripture reading, Joshua chapter 24. Allow me to read in your hearing, verse 14 and 15. Joshua chapter 24. And I'm going to ask you to do something for me today. When you get a chance, this today, this evening or tomorrow, or sometime in the coming week, read Joshua 23 and 24, chapter 23 and 24, and it will give you a bigger picture of our message today. Joshua chapter 24, allow me to read it in here, verses 14 and 15. Now therefore, fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in truth, and put away the gods which your fathers served on the other side of the flood, and in Egypt, and serve ye the Lord. And if it seems evil unto you to serve the Lord, choose you this day whom ye will serve, whether the gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the flood, or the gods of the Amorites, in whose land he dwelt. But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. I want to put a time in this text, and for the next few minutes, speak to you from the topic, a godly father. A godly father. For we come into your presence. And as we come today, we just come to praise you and to thank you for your goodness and your grace towards us. We come today, Lord, because we need to hear a word from you today. Oh God, may our desire be like Joshua, that we will serve the Lord in sincerity, and that if no one else wants to serve you, because of your goodness and your grace towards us, we and our house will serve you until we die. Come the mind closer to us today. Hide me behind the cross. Uplift Jesus alone, and let Jesus alone be seen and heard. You said, if I be uplifted, I draw all men unto you. So now come by here today. Tabernacle with us as we worship you. In Jesus' name, the church is Godly Father, as we celebrate this weekend, Father's Day, I want to give a shout out to all the fathers in this house. We thank God for you. We praise God for you. And we ask that God continue to bless you as you do your part in helping to show the world who a godly father is. We need fathers no more. And we thank God for the men and the fathers of the New Jersey Baptist Church.